Sorry guys, I ran out of video, so I'm gonna have to make this a two-parter. But like I said in the last video, this distilled water is to make this 3 or any tone even lighter. Say this 3 isn't light enough, you dip a little in this, and then a little in the distilled water, it's gonna lighten it even more. And you can also mix from this and with the white. When you mix a black with a little white, it's gonna give it a more satin effect. You know, more velvety when you're using white and black to mix it down. It's a pain in the ass to mix all your inks down with white. It's gonna give you more gray effect. But if you mix a little of this with a little white, you see how it's like a satin gray. Also, the distilled water is out for this purpose too. Sorry, I'm holding the camera now. It's for blood lining. Sorry, forgive me. Shouldn't be holding this, pain in the ass. When you're tattooing and you know this stencil is gonna wipe away and you don't want those lines to wipe away, you can either, if you're doing color, I just dip in straight water, and then you can, actually it's hard to do this into the camera. You can outline the whole piece in water and basically just give you a red line that'll eventually heal and go away. When I'm doing black and gray and I know I'm gonna shade off of it black and gray, I'll use the light 3%. You can see that's really light. Hold on, grab a paper towel. That light 3% will eventually fade away to nothing. So if you shade off of that, you won't see that anymore. So that's basically putting a permanent stencil on that you won't see after the tattoo's done, depending on the ink tones. Also, I'm gonna show you this, set up this machine, my favorite, which is my next gen, with the 15 round curved. When you're doing black and gray, dip a little, say I'm mixing out, you really wanna go surfacey. You can see how light this machine is. And I move quick, I'm just doing random circles. Now I'm gonna take it with the other hand, I'm gonna wipe it. And you see how unsaturated that is? You see how light it is? This paper, this is literally thin foam paper. And with a liner, you're actually able to cut right through this. You could rip this up, this shit is really soft. Now given this shit really doesn't hold the ink well with the shader, better for practice and line work. Actually, I'll show you on the other side. The new shop apprentice was learning line work on it. And look how good he got. I drew it out for him, and he lined it up, and he did a pretty badass job. This teaches you how to ad-lib. When you trace it, basically, this teaches you how to freehand shit on the skin. I drew it up for him to help, and he put all the details in, but you can see he tried to shade it, and it gets muddy. But this shit's really good for learning line work on. It'll hold the line, as you can see. When it comes to shading, it gets really muddy. So this is awesome to learn line work on. This is what I learned on, this and pigskin and fucking fruits. But like I said, you could tear this shit up easy. You see, I just ripped it up. But with a color packer sitting in the same spot like this, I would tear a hole right through them. This shit's good because if it starts to get torn up and you can see the styrofoam, the actual foam's getting all torn up, you know you would be tearing their skin up. So having a really good quality, light running gray wash shader is gonna basically, it's still possible to fuck somebody up, but it's gonna make it a lot harder to tear up the skin. And say I did this tone and I get through the rest of the tattoo and it's not dark enough, because you did it really light, you can see I'm going really surfacey. There's a lot of needles sticking out, so you're just sticking the tips in very painfully. I actually have a second chance to go over it without it tearing up. Now I'm gonna show you on this one. I'm gonna try to turn the give down a little bit. Hear that? I'm going right through the paper. This shit is so soft that it's actually softer than skin. So if you can pull a tattoo off on this shit without tearing it up, you'll do really good at not tearing up the skin on a client. But as you can see with the rotary with no give, it tore right through this. This is a big indent. You can see it went right through to the other side. But with this, I was doing constant circles and it didn't tear through it because it's got a lot of give. This not only prevents you from overworking the skin, it gets you smoother blends, and because it runs quick, you're not getting choppy blends. You can't do really smooth blends with a super slow running machine. I mean, it's possible, but that means you got to spend more time in one area, more trauma to the skin. The quicker you get through an area, the better the skin is. You don't want to stay in one area too long, hence why a gray wash shader should run, you know, quick and smooth. Unloaded, this runs around 122 and 54, and loaded, it's around 105 and, you know, around 52. Awesome machine. Given this is a next generation, I don't know if you're going to be able to see it, next generation stamped on it. This is a $300 machine. It's pretty expensive. You don't have to spend $300 to get a good gray wash shader. I'll show you some of my other daily use machines. My other gray wash shader here, which is a little longer spring. This is a generic, I think it's a ITS, International Tattoo Supply, just straight iron frame. And I took the time to rebuild it, cut custom springs, rewrap some coils, and this cost me like $40, and it runs just as well as the next gen. So if you take your time and build the machine, you're gonna have an awesome machine. On to my color packers, I use an Orion. Difference with this is it runs slow and it runs hard. My other color packer, just spilled the fucking water. That's why I always gotta be careful. Other color packer is an old Infinite Irons that's been rebuilt, heavy bar. This is my pride and my joy. This is super old, and I love the fuck out of it. It was my first machine ever given to me, my first professional machine. And then my long stroke liner, which has got a 4mm stroke and still runs around 137 to 140. This was a cheaper machine. This costs about $80 total from Monster Point. Awesome machine. So you can see I use a mix between expensive and cheap, whatever works. This is a cheaper liner. This was a cheaper liner. I just took the time to retune them and rebuild them. This is an intermediate. This is around $140, my favorite rotary of all time. Like you see, you can do smooth gray wash with it and you can pack straight color, you can line, you can bloodline. So it's not the amount of money you spend on it, it's the amount of time you put in your machines or the amount of time whoever put in your machines. I can't believe I just put that down on top of there. That's what you get for not paying attention. As you can see, the stencil stuff worked. It was an old stencil that I've already used once. It's the stencil for my arm. It was already previously used. You can see there. And then it's still not done. It's got all the detail work and the teeth to be added. I did that not that long ago out of boredom. I only got part of the way through it before it started to hurt and I gave up. It's actually going to be one of those masks, the smiley masks and the sad face. I forget what they're called. This side's the smiling one, and on the other arm, I'm going to put it on the same spot. There's going to be the sad face. There's going to be a big background behind it. You know, that's really it on my arm, nothing special. So hopefully you guys learned something from this video. Hopefully I helped you out. Guys, got any questions, feel free to ask. I am more than glad to help out. I know I made a mess. It's kind of hard to do this and make a video. Fast and soft machines have a blunt liner, a single pass liner, and then another soft machine that runs a little slower with a smaller needle for details. This is for the most of it. A big curved needle, you're just going to get smoother and more consistent blends. And also, if you have a big area, you're going to be able to do it twice as quick without getting frustrated. Trying to cover a big area like this with a 7 or a fucking 9 would kill me. Hence why I even use these on color. Color, I don't use the curve. Color, I'll actually use just a straight flat 15. It gives more consistent color, unless I'm doing color fading. So hopefully this helped. I'm sorry it's a two-part video for you guys. I actually had plenty of footage left on my camera, but I don't know why it just stopped recording. That's it. I'm out. I'm going back to my business. Remember, everything I say is just my opinion. This is how I set up my shit. This is how I do black and gray, and I know there's someone going to say out there that I'm wrong, I did this wrong, and you could be right. It works for me. My tattoos stand up for themselves. I don't need somebody to defend them. That's why anybody's ever talked shit to me on my channel, I really don't give a shit. My tattoos stand for themselves. I don't need to defend them. My work stands for itself. My work ethic, I'm fucking super sanitary. It's actually to the point of being fucking erotic. Everybody thinks I'm a nut. All I do is clean my station.
But that's it, guys. Like I said, you don't have to spend a lot of money. You don't have to go out and buy the best of the best inks. As long as you mix your shit correctly and it is a quality ink, you'd be good. I don't care if you spend $500 machine or $5 on a machine. Just spend the time, tune it to how it's supposed to be tuned, and have specific machines for specific jobs. As you can see, I use a bunch of different machines on a daily basis. Next Gen, Joey D, Monster Point, ITS, another Monster Point, a Kylin machine, and then a Hummingbird. And I have a few others that I use that I just don't have here. I couldn't bring them home. The box wasn't big enough. But you can see I use a variety of brands and prices, and they get the work done because all these machines are tuned or set correctly. So it doesn't matter if it's a $1,000 machine or a $5 machine. As long as it's tuned correctly to do this specific job. Like this, it runs so soft and quick, there's no way I could ever pack solid color with this. This runs so fucking slow and so hard, there's no way I could ever do consistent fucking black and gray with it. This runs so fucking punchy and pretty slow, I don't think I could bloodline with this. It just would come out weird. This is different on the other hand. This runs quick, or I can make it run slow. Super versatile machine. I can use this for single pass and bloodlining. Same with this. It's an all-around machine. Anyways, I'm out, guys. I'm going to upload these for you. I'm going to go finish my coffee, and y'all can fuck off. I'm kidding. New channel will be up soon. I actually got a few next gens I'm giving away and two Hummingbirds. They're the new Hummingbirds. Actually, I have the box here. Just got one of them today. New Hummingbird. They're the Maxon version. Same as these. Just have a Maxon motor. And I had somebody ask me, and I forget who it was, if they want to put a Maxon motor in their Hummingbird. I looked it up. I took one out of the other motor. The motor is a Maxon Remax DC motor. The model number is 216000, 17 millimeter motor with a 1.5 millimeter shaft. Just put in Maxon Remax and then 216000. That's the same size motor as this, but it's a Maxon. And the Maxon motor that comes in this, the new ones are the exact same as the Diablo Swiss. So you want to spend $500 or $400 on a Diablo Swiss because it has a Maxon motor. Everything on this is just as good of a quality. And it actually has the better rolling bar because its bearings, unlike the Diablo Swiss, is just that stupid plastic roller, which creates tension. Everything on this is just as good as a Diablo Swiss except for the motor. But now Hummingbirds come out with a Maxon version that's actually better than a Diablo Swiss. And I can say this because I have a red Diablo Swiss and I really don't like it. But the Diablo Swiss with the Maxon is $400. The Hummingbird with the Maxon is $220 to $250, depending on where you buy it. I'm out, guys. Email me for questions, McKinstryA@yahoo.com or bcbuilds11@gmail.com, or find me on Facebook. I'd be glad to answer all your questions or clarify any of this. I know I kind of random. I drink way too much fucking coffee. That's it. I'm out.